I love kinetic cinema. When I was curious about cinema, I read a book by Kevin Brownlow. Do you know Kevin Brownlow, who a critic and scholar who wrote a book in the 60s called The Parade's Gone By? And he pointed out that the syntax of cinema, the language which is about 120 years old, that everybody learns now, wherever they are, they learn to read moving image before they read their own language. That syntax, that language of cinema was invented by the silent filmmakers because there's no sound, and it was invented by that. And so I went back and studied the likes of Buster Keaton and all those filmmakers, and that's what why it's that's why I love kinetic cinema.
정말 놀랍고 압도적이었던 것이 그 이동, 운동 또는 차나 오토바이가 질주하는 것 자체가 그거 자체가 내러티브를 끌고 가고 지배한다는 거였어요. 그러니까 액션이나 움직임을 멈춘 상태에서 누군가 스토리를 설명하고 다시 또 엔진에 시동을 걸고 이게 아니라 그 질주하는 운동과 그 움직이는 이미지와 폭주하는 엔진들 그 자체가 내러티브를 끌고 가는 방식이고 어찌 보면 한 방향으로 질주하다가 이제 이들이 방향을 180도 바꿔서 다시 시타델로 돌아가는 그런데 그 자체가 되게 강력하고 독창적인 내러티브를 만들어내는데 그 멈추지 않는 운동 자체가 그 스토리텔링 자체를 이제 성립하게 하는 그런 것들 그런 경지를 어떻게 직업적 비밀에 대해서 좀 알고 싶은
Well, what happened was when I made the early Mad Max films, I wasn't interested in doing any more. And then what happened in the early 90s, I began to, I was lucky enough to still be making films with during the digital era. And digital filmmaking, I believe, has changed so much. I learned that from the animation movies and so on. And I thought, wouldn't it be wonderful to make a film using the new tools? You can do things with digital cinema that you could never do before. Purely on the level of safety, for instance. You can put cables and wires on your actors and stuntmen where the danger level comes down quite a bit. It still has to be very, very precise, but you're able to do it in that way.